Now I call upon Justice Yahya Afridi, who's written a separate short order. You want to read it or you want to summarize it?
Okay. For reasons to be recorded later, civil appeal number so-and-so, civil petition number so-and-so, CMA number so-and-so are dismissed in terms that Sunni Ittehad Council does not fulfill the conditions prescribed for a political party under the enabling provisions of the Constitution of Islamic Republic of Pakistan and the law to be allowed allocated reserved seats for women and non-Muslims in the National Assembly or the Provincial Assemblies. Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf fulfills the conditions prescribed for a political party under the enabling provisions of the Constitution and the law to be allowed allocated reserved seats for women and non-Muslims in terms that a candidate for a seat in the National Assembly or the Provincial Assembly who in his or her nomination paper has declared on oath to belong to PTI and duly submitted a certificate of the same political party confirming that he, she is the nominated candidate of PTI for the respective constituency shall remain so and cannot be declared independent unless he, she submitted a written declaration to the Election Commission of Pakistan or the returning officer to be treated as a candidate of another political party or as an independent candidate. A returned candidate to the National Assembly or the Provincial Assembly who in his nomination paper has declared on oath to belong to PTI and duly submitted a certificate of the same political party confirming that he, she is the nominated candidate of PTI for the respective constituency shall remain so. And this consistent position maintained by a returned candidate throughout the electoral process should be legally recognized by the Election Commission of Pakistan, and such returned candidate cannot be treated as a returned candidate of any other political party or as an independent candidate, returned candidate. And thus, the reserved seats for women and non-Muslims are to be allocated, allotted to PTI accordingly. A candidate nominated by PTI for a constituency of a National Assembly or a Provincial Assembly who, after being declared returned, joined another party or sought to be treated as an independent, raises serious concerns about disregarding the trust reposed in him or her by the voters, thus undermining the will of the people. And number four, the legal implications, effects, consequences of the determination made above in paragraph 2.2 and 2.3, as well as the actions or inactions of Election Commission of Pakistan thereon, although deeply concerning, have not been challenged in the present appeals and petitions, and the persons who would be affected or aggrieved are not parties before this court, therefore issuing a definite direction to the Election Commission qua the allocation of specified number of reserved seats for women and non-Muslims to a political party in the National Assembly and the Provincial Assembly would not be legally appropriate. Accordingly, the Election Commission of Pakistan is directed to decide the allocation of reserved seats for women and non-Muslims to political parties in the National Assembly and the Provincial Assembly in the light of the determinations made herein above, after providing opportunity of hearing to the parties concerned, and if required, revisit its earlier decisions on the matter. The needful be done within 7 days of receipt of this order. Thank you.
Thank you. Justice Aminuddin Khan, sir.
For the reasons to be recorded later, I dismiss the appeals, petitions, as well as CMAs, and the judgment of the Peshawar High Court is upheld.
Has anyone agreed with you?
My Lord, I, Justice Naeem Akhtar, concur with Honorable Justice Aminuddin Khan, and for the reasons to be recorded later on, I am also dismissing all the appeals, petitions, and CMAs and uphold the judgment of the Peshawar High Court.
Thank you. Now I read Justice Jamal Khan Mandukhil's order, with which I agree. For the reasons to be recorded later, we dispose of these appeals, petitions, and miscellaneous applications through a short order as under. These matters involve a controversy regarding the allocation of seats reserved for women and non-Muslims. The Sunni Ittehad Council, SIC, did not contest the general elections of the year 2024. SIC, which demands allocation of reserved seats on account of inclusion of independent parliamentarians in it, did not secure a single seat in the National Assembly or any of the provincial assemblies, nor submitted a list of its candidates for seats reserved for women and non-Muslims. Thus, it is not entitled to any of the reserved seats either in the National Assembly or in the provincial assemblies. The impugned judgment in order dated 1st March 2024 of the Election Commission of Pakistan, hereinafter ECP, to such extent is upheld. Under Article 51 within bracket 3 of the Constitution of the Islamic Republic of Pakistan, the total number of seats in the National Assembly shall be 326, out of which 60 seats are reserved for women and 10 seats for non-Muslims. Such right of women and non-Muslims has been guaranteed by the Constitution. They shall be elected in accordance with law through proportional representation system of political parties list of candidates on the basis of total number of general seats secured by each political party from the province concerned in the National Assembly and the provincial assemblies as provided by Article 51 within bracket 6 clauses D and E of the Constitution. Therefore, they cannot be deprived of their such right by leaving these seats vacant, and all reserved seats shall be filled in as provided by Article 224(6) of the Constitution. The impugned judgment of the High Court and the said order of the ECP to the extent of proportional representation, distribution of seats amongst the parties which won and secured seats is also maintained. However, since the ECP calculated and allocated the seats to the parties by the exclusion of the Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf, PTI, candidates, therefore to such extent the impugned judgment of the High Court and the order of the ECP are set aside. During the hearing, it transpired that a number of candidates had submitted their nomination papers with a declaration on oath that they belonged to PTI supported by an affiliation certificate of the said party. But some did not submit affiliation certificates of PTI. They are members of national and respective provincial assemblies affiliated with PTI. The ECP, by misinterpreting the judgment of this court dated 13 January 2024, which was regarding non-holding intra-party elections in PTI, wrongly mentioned the said candidates of the PTI as independents in Form 33 of the election rules. The ECP had no authority to declare validly nominated candidates of a political party to be independent candidates. Similarly, a candidate once declared himself or herself as a candidate of a political party could not subsequently resign from his candidature of a particular party after the last date of withdrawal of the nomination papers. It is important to mention here that neither the PTI nor any candidate affiliated with PTI approached either this court before or during the hearing of these proceedings or the High Court to challenge the decision of the ECP, declaring them as independents. However, in view of the fact that the appeal and the petition are a continuation of election proceedings before the ECP, we can look into the vagaries of the decision of the ECP in the light of the provisions of Article 51D and E of the Constitution, read with Sections 66, 67 and 104 of the Elections Act 2017, to safeguard the interest of women and non-Muslims. As a consequence whereof, the candidates who had submitted the nomination papers and or affiliation certificates by the last date of withdrawal of the nomination papers declaring that they belong to PTI and had not filed a document showing affiliation with another political party should have been treated as parliamentary, as the parliamentary party of PTI. But needful was not done by the ECP. Consequently, the PTI as a parliamentary party is entitled to the reserved seats to such extent that ECP should recalculate and reallocate the reserved seat amongst the political parties, including the PTI, as provided by Article 51, 6, D and E of the Constitution. The candidates who had submitted the nominations papers by 24 December 2023, which was the last date of submission of nomination papers, and had declared themselves either as the independent candidates or left blank the relevant column in the nomination papers declaration and were elected, shall be considered to be independents. SIC is a registered political party, and every independent member of parliament and the provincial assemblies has a right to join it. All those who joined the SIC are presumed to have done so out of their own free will. None of them claim to have joined SIC because of any misunderstanding of any judgment, the law, compulsion, coercion, or undue influence. And it is not for this court to presume otherwise. We must ensure that words are not read into the Constitution, nor to ascribe artificial meaning to commonly understood words. We must also abide by validly enacted laws and must not do anything either to hinder or to facilitate a political party by ignoring the law's mandate. I think this concludes today's proceedings. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Sir Honor. Thank you so very much.